When I presented Navakash, this question came from different places. Many visitors, many guests on that opening day asked me, what is Superflat? The basic question was, is it because the works are flat in nature? They are painted very flatly on the canvas without creating any visual depth. Is it because of that? So my answer is partly yes. They are flat because they are painted in a flat fashion. But here, why as curator I chose that particular word, super flat, or particular concept of super flat, because Navakash has been painting very flat pictures, even if they visually give some kind of a three-dimensionality or visually give some kind of a depth, because they are optical. They have this oak art quality. You must be knowing about the works of Frank Stella and all. Look at it and you start seeing some kind of a depth which actually creates certain circles, squares, or moving, some kind of a virtual kinetics you could see on the canvases. So that is one part of it. Why Superflat? Because despite all these optical illusions and optical effects, the flatness that he wanted to create, or he has been creating since the day I saw him here, his works in the studio, and the ones that I exhibited in the gallery, I noticed this flatness, and immediately I was reminded of Takashi Murakami.
So this is one of the super flat paintings done by Navakash. Now I will explain why I equate or I make parallels of Navakash with Takashi Murakami. Takashi Murakami actually didn't do any geometrical forms or geometrical images that you see here in Navakash's work. You can see a lot of stripes, lot of circles, lot of repetitive images in Navakash's works. Murakami was not doing that. But if you look at the circles, and if you try to see Takashi Murakami's works, you can see this particular flowers, which he calls as Kai Kai Kiki. They comes repeatedly. So they look like happy flowers. And when people look at those works, they feel that they are looking at some happy advertisement. So they are giving you a kind of happiness, as if you were looking at something extremely happy, open, celebratory, and so on. Here, when you look at Navakash's works, here also you can see that there are a lot of happy feelings emanating from the colors and the images that he has created. And both these artists, Navakash and Takashi Murakami, make it extremely flat. And now I will tell you from where Takashi Murakami is coming from. Takashi Murakami hails from that background of Japanese art scene, which is dominated by the manga and anime ways of expression.
From that particular scenario or zeitgeist of Japan, where anime and manga tradition were in vogue. They are still in vogue, and most of the contemporary artists, contemporary youngsters, revel in this anime and manga style in Japan, and that has become a fad world over. Takashi Murakami picked it up from there, that particular tradition. And also the Japanese woodcut tradition called ukiyo-e. He was also influenced by that particular tradition of woodcut. One particular thing that makes all these styles important is their super flatness. They avoid all kinds of spatial depth or depth or illusionary depths. Murakami likes to paint the happy pictures because they are very positive. They give a lot of positive impression.
And it is not just Takashi Murakami. A whole lot of artists used to play around with super flatness, especially during the 1960s and 70s. As you know, when pop art was in fashion in the Western art world, Roy Lichtenstein, Andy Warhol, artists like that, Eduardo Paulosi, all these kind of some artists, they also used a lot of super flat paintings. Interestingly, super flat is not something that started with Takashi Murakami or the pop artist of the West. Super flat has always been there. If you look at the history of art, right from the cave paintings, you can see then the human beings, the human artists of that time, were trying to create a three-dimensionality, but they were not able to capture it. So if you look at the whole of the history, it has always been flat. The human effort was to make it three-dimensional. By Renaissance, you get this three-dimensionality achieved by artists like Giotto, and later on by Da Vinci and all. And when we come to the Mughal miniatures, the Mughal painting, you can see there is flatness. Or all the miniature traditions of India, you can see this flatness. And the greatest achievement, if we consider the greatest achievement, was attaining the three-dimensionality. Later on, it became an achievement in terms of achieving super flatness.